yourselves briefly.
So I'm Lisa and I'm a PhD student at ICFO.
I'm Jonas, I'm also a PhD student here at ICFO, and in our work we use light to study the brain in healthy and diseased people. And in particular we use near-infrared light, so in other words reddish light, which allows us to obtain information from deeper tissues such as the brain.
And we do that by using optical fibers like the one that we see here. So for example, if we're interested in measuring the brain, I would put the fibers like this on the forehead and retrieve information from the brain. And using this information, we can, for example, try to help clinicians develop better treatments.
That's so fascinating. So what about the study that you have recently done? Can you explain that in a few words?
Sure. So last year in August, after the first wave of the COVID-19 pandemic, we were interested in the effects of face masks on the brain. So in particular, we wanted to show that wearing a face mask does not deprive any the oxygen level in the brain, and we are not excessively rebreathing carbon dioxide or anything like this.
And then also, so those were the main concerns of wearing face masks, that they might be dangerous. But also, since we're interested in neuroimaging studies, neuromonitoring studies, we wanted to see whether the possible changes in the physiology and in the brain of wearing a face mask, whether that might be affecting our signals.
Interesting. So how exactly did you do this?
So we studied the effects of wearing two different kinds of face masks. This one that I'm holding here is a surgical face mask. So this is a common mask that many people wear every day.
And these here are FFP2 face masks. Is the European standard, and which were recommended by many governments and institutions.
Okay, and how did you look at their effects?
So we looked at young people, healthy young people at rest. So we just asked them to sit and read a paper, and after some time, so we started off with our subjects not wearing any mask, and then after some time we put on a mask. And throughout this time, we were monitoring what was happening inside of their brain using these optical techniques, and then also what was happening inside of the body using different monitors.
And so we did the study here at ICFO. So it was COVID-19 times, so we had to recruit only subjects here from the institute according to the regulations. So we ended up recruiting only healthy young subjects with a median age of 27 years.
Okay, and what did you find from the study?
So the main thing, if we talk about the physiology, so what's happening in the body, not in the brain, is that there's really no changes. So wearing a face mask won't change the amount of oxygen that's in your body, and it also won't change the amount of carbon dioxide, so that's good news.
And even if we look now at the brain, there's no change in the oxygenation, or there's a small increase even in the oxygenation. And if we look at the oxygen metabolism, we haven't found a change. And if we look at these changes and compare them to daily activities, such as you get attention by something, so your brain gets stimulated by, for instance, watching a movie or seeing someone moving around, these changes are even bigger than what we've seen while wearing a mask.
So that's good news for the use of masks in the public. Do you have any other extra messages you want to deliver?
So the main thing is that it seems that wearing a face mask won't cause any adverse effects if you are at rest. Also, that we can measure these small changes that Jonas mentioned. It shows that our devices and our methodology allows us to measure very small changes. So they're very sensitive. So we have a great method in order to study this kind of question.
So even if we look now at different subjects with three existing conditions, respiratory problems, they might respond differently, and our tools would allow us to study this. And to add on this, if we look at the last 1.5 years, we all have been running around with the masks. We are all still here, so mask wearing is safe. And in that sense, I would say stay healthy and safe and wear a face mask.
Thank you very much. Very important message indeed.